If aliens arrived on Earth to abduct our most successful inhabitant, where would they look?
Neverland. Are they aliens?
I think that's
how the hell did you get a shot of them?
I just...
An alien boy band.
It's Hubble for you. Yeah,
alien
boy band.
It's like alien YMCA.
They would look and see which was the most successful form of life.
Cockroaches.
On Earth.
Cockroaches.
Are you talking about the amount of awards?
Bacteria.
Bacteria is the right answer.
Bacteria.
By far. I mean, any criterion by which you judge the success of life, bacterium win hands down in terms of profusion, diversity, ability to live under extraordinary conditions.
But nobody likes them, do they?
Well, yeah. We wouldn't be alive without them. We entirely depend upon them. If chicken had no bacteria, it would be completely tasteless. It would not taste anything. Well, that's true of almost all food.
Cheese, of course.
Bacteria. There's only a very small number of bacteria dangerous. If you were to take a gram of soil, there are 40,000 species of different bacteria in that 1 gram, let alone the amount there are. And each species is as different from each other as a rhinoceros is from a primrose. I mean, they're amazing things. I wanted to fall in love with the bacterium. They are just the most marvellous things conceivable.
Really, so me.
They live in boiling acid. They live in ice. They live in nuclear cooling water. I mean, they can live absolutely anywhere under 6,000 atmospheres of pressure.
Where's their favourite place, though? Where do they really like to hang out?
Human tummy.
They live in
They love the human tummy. We reckon 75% of the bacteria in the tummy have not yet really been identified as separate species. They're fantastic. But they do exist all over the place.
What about pygmies, though? Surely pygmies are more hardy, aren't they? they can live anywhere in the world.
There's a lot more comedy in
pygmies
them.
Pygmies can live
bacteria.
Oh, bloody hell, so warm up on the bacteria, guess.
So why do you say that pygmies are...
Well, because you say successful, you're imbuing them with some sort of human characteristics.
No, I'm not. No, I mean successful in purely Darwinian terms.
Are they all invisible to the naked eye, or are there any kind of cat-sized...
No, they're all...
one as a pet, big, hairy bacteria.
No, they look it under microscopes, some of them, don't they? They have pathogenic sex, as it were, amongst them, each to the other. Virgin birth, you know? They divide and split and divide and...
like amoebas.
Reproduce their DNA, which is...
Yeah. How many amoebas did they... There's a light bulb. One, no, two, no, four, no, eight, no, six, 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 120, stop! Stop!
Very good indeed.
Thank you for watching. Do remember to subscribe to the QI channel and click here to watch more videos.